Good morning, students. Today we are checking the poem of class 11. And the name of the poem is A Photograph Written by Sandeep Das. Actually, this poem is Shirley's autobiographical poem. Because in this poem, she is just recalling the memories of her past. How she spent her time with her mother and how the things took place that time. The mother is no more in this world, but the memories are still alive in her mind. And how she is living with those memories of the past and what kind of feelings she has after so many years, after the loss of her mother. All these things that she is describing in this poem, a photograph. Actually, a photograph, there is a photograph that is in a frame hanging on the wall of the poet's house in her room. And there is a picture of three girls there in the photograph. There are two younger girls and in the middle there is a just older and taller girl. That older and taller girl is actually poet's mother. When she was about 12 years. And actually the three girls with their uncle had gone to enjoy the picnic holiday at the sea beach. And there what happened, how the picture was snapped, how the photograph was taken by uncle and how it looks this time. All these things have been very beautifully described by the poet in this poem. Let me just read this poem first. The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands, and see the big girl, some 12 years or so, all three stood still to smile through their hair, and uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. And see, which appears to have changed less, was their terribly transient fate. Actually, this photograph is in the frame of cardboard. And when this actual photograph was taken, what had happened? There are three girls and they had gone to just enjoy their picnic holiday at the sea beach. And just paddling, while paddling in the water of the sea, they are hair open and the fish on their smile, and they are in the swimming suit. And uncle just asked them to make a pose, a sweet face. And he and the two girls, the three girls, the two, they actually two are the cousin sisters of his mother. The girl in the middle, the older and taller one, is actually author's mother, is the poet's mother. And the two girls, the two girl cousins, they are just holding the fingers of poet's mother. And in a beautiful pose, in a sweet pose, the uncle takes the photograph. And that photograph becomes a sweet memory of mother's past. That photograph, and the poet says how the things have changed from that time. That photograph is hanging just in the wall of the room. Things have changed from that time. From a young, very young girl, the mother, just after 20 or 30 years actually, and the poet was born. And whenever she would look at the picture, her mother would look at the picture, she would laugh. The things have changed. Actually, the poet's mother from a younger girl, actually she just grows and she's married and she gives birth to a child. It is the fish that was on the sea beach, in the sands of the beach. The feet, the print of the feet is no more there. It is not there. It has been washed away by the water of the sea. But the means and the sea has not yet changed. There is no change in the quality of the sea. There is no change in the vastness of the sea. There is no change in the character of the sea. Sea is in the same condition, but the mother's feet and her cousin sister's feet, they have been washed away. This was the difference between the existence of the temporary things and the existence of the permanent things in this world. How nature is permanent? The poet wants to say actually through that nature is permanent. Human life is temporary. Human life is just short. It is washed away. It is finished after some time. But nature's vastness, nature's enormous appearance or existence in this world is permanent. This is the difference between the human life and nature. I think many other poems you might have just read about the permanence quality of nature and the temporariness of human life. Some 20, 30 years later, she would laugh at the snaps. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her laughter. Both reap with the labored ease of loss. And 20 and 30 years later, when actually the poet was born and she had become somewhat young, and when mother would look at the photograph, she would laugh. She would love to see the smiling face of the girls, her own face also there, and how they were just dressed up for the swimming in the sea. Betty and Dolly, her two cousin sisters, are there. So seeing the picture, the smile and the dress, the short dress actually for swimming, the mother would laugh. And the poet would see her mother laughing. She would laugh. Mother would laugh to remember her past. The past of that sea holiday. That the time that they had actually spent there. And that is her mother's past. Spend time just at the beach of the sea. And the poet's past is mother's laugh. When she would laugh looking at the picture, this is the poet's past. So she remembers the past of her mother just by remembering how her mother would just laugh while looking at the picture. And the poet says, both real, that holiday picnic at the sea beach is mother's past. And mother's laughter is the poet's past. And both ring with the labored ease of loss. Mother just laughed, and also she became sad to think that the time is gone. The time will not be just will be coming in her life again. So a sense of loss was also in the mind of the poet's mother when she would laugh at the picture. And when the poet is remembering her mother's laugh, she has also a sense of loss because mother is no more in this world. So a sense of joy, just imbued with a sense of loss, was there in the mother's laughter also. And the mother's remembrance of that past incident, and in the poet's remembrance of the mother's laugh, there is a sense of joy and the sense of loss, because the actually that time is not going to be just re-enjoyed in her life, or not going to come in her life again. So that is why the poet says, both three with the labored ease of loss. It is an oxymoron. Labored ease means there is the pain and there is the joy. The mixture of pain and joy, both at the same time, very contradictory. That is a figure of speech used by the poet Lebert is oxymoron. Now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. And of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. This is a very, actually, the pathetic picture of the poet's expression here that can be seen here. That now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. The poet's mother is gone. She is dead. And she had been dead for 12 years. Means the same age, the same number of the age when that picture was taken, when that photograph was taken, she was 12 years old or so. And now, after her death, 12 years time has elapsed. And the poet, after 12 years, after the death of her mother, she remembers this, the situation here. And of this circumstance, there's nothing to say at all. Because mother is gone. There is no physical presence of a mother in her life. And this circumstance is so sad, is so painful for the poet. She can just only remember her past with mother, but she cannot just re-enjoy those things. So mother, the death silenced mother, and this situation, the absence of her mother in her life, that makes the poet speechless. The poet also becomes speechless because of this loss. So it is very painful for the poet to remember to actually that time that she had spent with her mother. A loss, a memory that brings loss in her mind. And she recalls the time, but that recalling of the time makes her quite unhappy. So this is the poem that, the photograph, that the poet expresses her inner feelings of the past that she had and of the present and the mixture of the two in this poem to recall the things that had taken place actually in the past with her mother. So this is all about this poem, the photograph. This is a single question and answer of this poem. Next.